Now then, here we have a fish. And to give you some idea about how it is preserved, what I'm going to do is dip it into two things, which we must pretend for today are liquid rock. And I should first of all going to put it in this. And because this rock is nice and liquid like this, I need to freeze it very quickly indeed. Now, the freezing process to accelerate it, which has got nothing at all to do with the fossil record, is using liquid nitrogen. And we put it in like that, freeze in that direction, out it goes. Poor fish. Then we put it into the thing like that, and we repeat this process, because what I'm trying to demonstrate is how the mineral salts precipitate themselves round the fish in alternate layers. And of course, we then have a fossilisation, like that. Goodness me. This is science with a fun. And you end up with something which, on the outside, is really a pretty shapeless object. But we know, of course, that inside it there is a fish lurking. But again, if you're the fossil hunter, you might well find something like that in the field, crack it open, and reveal the fish within. But is it absolutely necessary always to attack everything you find with a hammer and chisel? Do you have to bang everything open? Do you have to hurl things apart to reveal the internal fossils? Sometimes, of course, you do. But there are more subtle ways in which we can approach this particular problem. And by way of an introduction, what we have in here is a mystery object. And we've got to imagine that this is preserved in exactly the same way as the nodules which I just showed you there. Now, a scientific method, which is very widely used, is to actually find chemicals, weak acids, which can etch away the outside layers and so reveal the internal fish within. Now, this, of course, has to be an incredibly delicate process, so that when I start to do this here, the amount of effervescence, the activity which is going on like this, is very much more rapid than what we would seek to do in the laboratory. But all the time, as you can see, the chemical here is etching into the nodule substance, the white material on the outside, and as it etches in that direction, so in due course, we hope it will reveal exactly what is there. Now, I think that's going to take a minute or two, so I'll leave that just to sort of bob around like that while you can engage in guessing games as to what might be concealed within. Because again, this has a real scientific purpose. What we see in this example here is precisely what paleontologists, the people who study the fossils, use to examine the remains of certain ancient life. Now here, I really have to keep my hands incredibly still because we have two of the most fantastic fossils imaginable, which actually come from Australia. They're about 350, roughly, million years old. And just gives you some idea. Let me just pick this up. I have to work with this one terribly slowly. It's a wonderful specimen. Because what's happening in that tank there has been done with much more care in this fossil. Here is the remains of the nodule. And can you see the fossil fish preserved within it? Do you see the head here? Every bone is in place. And then the scales of the fish are back like that. And then here, all the scales are loose. Perhaps this end of the fish was beginning to rot away. Do you see the way the scales are much more disturbed, much more difficult to see? And all of this has been revealed by just the same process as we see in this area here. Delicate, very delicate etching by weak acids. And I put that back, holding my heart still. This other specimen I simply will not pick up. It is much too delicate. But that skull, in fact, it comes from a fossil fish, is the same age as this fish. It's from the same deposit. And the whole of that skull has been isolated from this constant etching away of this nodule-like material here. So there, that is almost indistinguishable from some sort of modern preparation. That's the sort of thing which after you've had dinner and eaten a fish, perhaps, that's more or less what you see. Yet this is hundreds of millions of years old. If I did pick that up, I won't, the jaws could open, you can see inside its mouth. It's an absolutely startling specimen. Now, I do fear that the rate at which is, things are coming clear. If I just turn that slowly, I think you can begin to see that yes, indeed, there is, not surprising, yet another fish about to emerge. But we'll leave that to fizz away in its acid bath, and within about 10 minutes or so, that thing will be completely free of its encasing material, a standard technique which is very widely used.